Hallelujah.
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 Jesus, we praise you.
Jesus, we praise you.
Jesus, we glorify you.
Jesus, we glorify you.
Jesus, we adore you.
Jesus, we adore you.
Let us praise and worship the Lord.
Hallelujah.
For this day. Hallelujah.
Thank you, Jesus.
Hallelujah.
Thank you, Jesus.
Hallelujah. 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 Thank you, Jesus. Praise you, Jesus. We glorify you and adore you, Lord. Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
Who is like the Lord? There is no one who is like the Lord. He is strong and mighty. Who is like the Lord? He is worthy. Stand up and give him your praise. Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. Our God is worthy of glory. From the rising of the sun,
amen,
to his going down, the name of the Lord is to be praised. Stand up and praise him and give him your glory. Stand up and praise him and give him your glory. Stand up and praise him and give him your glory. Our God is worthy to be praised.
Lord, you are worthy of all praise and honor and adoration and worship. We all sing together and thank you for the wonderful gifts you are giving to us, bestowing on us.
Who is like the Lord? There is no one. Who is like the Lord? He is strong and mighty. Who
Jesus.
Is like the Lord? He is worthy. Stand up and give him your praise. Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. Our God is from the rising of the sun to its going down, the name of the Lord is to be praised. Stand up and praise him and give him your glory. Stand up and praise him and give him your glory. Stand up and praise him and give him your glory. Stand up and praise him and give him your glory.
Hallelujah.
Stand up and praise him and give
hallelujah.
Him your glory.
Hallelujah.
Praise him and
hallelujah.
Him glory.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
Praise.
Praise and worship the Lord. Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Worship and praise you, Lord Jesus. Hallelujah. 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 Hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah. Hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah. Hallelujah, hallelujah. Lord God Almighty, worthy of all praise and honor, we adore and thank you once again. Lord, today, as we are gathered, as we watch this episode, let all the people be filled with God's grace. Let all the sick people be healed in Jesus' name. As the word of God was spoken by Saint Peter, all those who heard the word of God were filled with the Holy Spirit. And today, as the word of God is being heard, Lord, let everyone be filled with the power of the Holy Spirit. We make this prayer through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Amen.
Amen. Amen.
Praise the Lord.
Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Today we are going to meditate upon a verse from the Bible. Book of Sirach, chapter 27, verse 1. The word of God says, there are so many people who have committed sins for silly reasons or maybe small profits. Let us listen to that.
For the sake of profit, many sin, and the struggle for wealth blinds the eyes.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
There are so many people who commit sin for a very silly profits. Maybe for money, maybe for some pleasure, whatever may be, many of the people are committing sins for silly profits. Our forefathers, Adam and Eve, the first parents, they committed sin for a very silly reason. The word of God says, though God had promised or God had commanded not to eat the fruit of a tree, Eve saw that fruit as delightful. And when you come to the book of Genesis, chapter 12, we see God is asking Abraham to leave his place, his, his kinsmen and everything and go after him. Let's hear that. Book of Genesis chapter 12 verse 1 onwards.
The Lord said to Abraham, go forth from the land of your kinsfolk and from your father's house to a land that I will show you.
The God is telling to leave his land and his all his belongings and to go to a land which God shows him. The second verse.
I will make of you a great nation and I will bless you. I will make your name great so that you will be a blessing.
Hallelujah.
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 God told him, you come after me or you go to the place where I show, then you are going to be a blessing. And you will have a great generation and that whole generation will be blessed. And that was the promise given to Abraham. Of course, Abraham was such a faithful person. He accepted what God said and he was ready to go to the place where God led him. But he did a small mistake. A small mistake. The small mistake was that when God asked Abraham to go, to leaving aside all his relatives, he was supposed to take only his wife Sarah with him. Abraham was very old and he thought, if I go alone, it will be a bit difficult for me. So what he thought? He thought, I will take Lot with me. And of course, if Lot is taken, his wife has to be taken with him. So it was a relation, or this was something which God did not want. When we come into the chapter 13 of Genesis, we see, dear friends, there is a great fight among the servants of Abraham and Lot. Hallelujah.
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 And there we see they are fighting each other. And finally, when the servants were fighting each other, Abraham understood and he went and told Lot in this way. That we see chapter 13 verse 8 onwards.
So Abraham said to Lot, let there be no strife between you and me, or between your herdsmen and mine, for we are kinsmen. Is not the whole land at your disposal? Please separate from me. If you prefer the left, I will go to the right. If you prefer the right, I will go to the left. Lot looked about and saw how well watered the whole Jordan plain was, as far as Soar, like the Lord's own garden, or
Hallelujah.
Like Egypt.
So what happened? Looking, one area was so good, Lot took that place and he went away. And Abraham into the other side. And you see, dear friends, in the verse 14, it is said,
after Lot had left, the Lord said to Abraham, look about you, and from where you are, gaze to the north and south, east and west. All the land that you see, I will give it to you and your descendants forever.
Hallelujah.
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 See, dear friends, sometimes it can happen that you don't receive blessings because of some friendship which God doesn't want. So sometimes it can happen that through your friends, the friendship or maybe the relation with some people can hinder the blessing in your life. Hallelujah.
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 Dear friends, another example we see in the book of same Genesis, we see that Jacob the sons of Isaac, Jacob and Esau. Esau and Jacob both are sons of Isaac. And we see in the chapter 25 that Esau sells his birthright for a cup of pottage. Hallelujah.
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 We see in the book of Genesis chapter 25 verse 27 onwards. We'll listen to that.
As the boys grew up, Esau became a skillful hunter, a man who lived in the open, whereas Jacob was a simple man who kept to his tents. Isaac preferred Esau because he was fond of game, but Rebekah preferred Jacob. Once when Jacob was cooking a stew, Esau came in from the open, famished. He said to Jacob, let me gulp down some of that red stuff.
Hallelujah. Yeah.
Hallelujah.
So we know the story. When Esau was so hungry coming and he got the smell of a stew that was made by Jacob, and he is just asking, I am so hungry, I feel so happy to have a cup of stew, please would you give that? And Jacob was so nice, and but he was very cunning. He said, okay, I can give you that, but just one thing, you give me the birthright. And you know what happened? In the book of Hebrews chapter, in the book of Hebrews chapter 12 verse 16,
that no one be an immoral or profane person like Esau, who sold his birthright for a single meal. For you know that later when he wanted to inherit his father's
blessings,
he was rejected because he found no opportunity to change his mind.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
And the next sentence says,
even though he sought the blessing with tears.
Even though he sought the blessings with the tears, he couldn't get back. Dear brothers and sisters, today for silly prophets, if you commit sins, what happened? You lose the grace from your heart. You lose the Holy Spirit. And after some time, you will fall into greater sins. Though it may begin with the small ones, slowly, slowly, the sin will creep and will make you a slave of sins. And finally, you are going to lead yourself, you are going to destroy yourself. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Again, we have another incident in the Acts of the Apostles. There we see, dear friends, in chapter 5 of the Acts of the Apostles, there we see two people, Ananias and Sapphira. Both of them were really, they became Christians and they wanted to give themselves totally to God. But what has happened? It's a very tragic event. We see, we hear from the book of Acts of the Apostles, chapter 5, verse 1 onwards.
A man named Ananias, however, with his wife Sapphira, sold a piece of property. He retained for himself, with his wife's knowledge, some of the purchase price, took the remainder and put it at the feet of the apostles.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah. The first Christians, what they did? They did what they did was, they sold their properties and they were just giving the whole money at the feet of the apostles. Because they had everything in common. They did not have any private property. And though these Sapphira and Ananias, what they did, they sold their land, but they kept a small portion of money for themselves. And the rest of the money, they gave to the disciples. And you know what happened? Though they had done it without the knowledge of many people, and without the knowledge of anybody, what happened? It was known to the apostles. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Read the rest of it.
But Peter said, Ananias, why has Satan filled your heart so that you lied to the Holy Spirit and retained part of the price of the land? While it remained unsold, did it not remain yours? And when it was sold, was it not still under your control? Why did you contrive this debt?
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
And you know what happened? Dear brothers and sisters, you know the story again. And this man, for a silly reason, St. Peter asked him, was not yours this land? You had every right on that. You could have kept everything. But you tried to cheat the Holy Spirit. And today, these examples, when the Bible presents before us, it is a warning for each and every one of you. You are a child of God and you can be no more a child of God by doing silly sins for small profits. Let's stand up. Let's pray to the Lord. Lord, give the awareness that even the smallest sin that when we commit, we are ruining ourselves. The Holy Spirit is paining. The Holy Spirit really feels so unhappy within us. And finally, the Holy Spirit will leave my body and my heart. And today we pray, Lord. There are so many people who do small sins for small profits. Let us not be one among them. Let us be righteous before the Lord. Let us open our hearts and ask the Lord to bless us. Hallelujah, hallelujah. Oh Lord, we ask today, give the grace and courage to avoid the sins for silly reasons. For a small profit, let us not be foolish enough to throw away the graces that we have received. Just like Esau, he threw away his birthright for a cup of stew. So too, we shall not do it. Our Holy Spirit strengthen us. Our Holy Spirit fill our hearts. Encourage us. We pray.
Let me not conform any longer to the pattern set by the ways of the world. May I offer myself as a living sacrifice that is holy and pleasing. Sanctify me.
Sanctify me.
Cleanse
me, Lord.
Cleanse my body
and soul.
Mind and soul.
Oh, Holy Spirit,
purify me.
Oh, purify me.
Make me whole.
By the precious blood of Jesus.
Sanctify me.
Glory, 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 glory. Hallelujah, hallelujah. Praise and glory, 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 glory. Shri Aramabadi. May Christ bless you one and all. Praise the Lord.
Praise the
Hallelujah.
Lord.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Let us stand in adoration and worship the Lord as we welcome Jesus into our midst.
Jesus, we love you. We praise and adore you.
All those who call out the name of Jesus will be saved. Let us call out the name of Jesus. Jesus, hallelujah, Jesus, Jesus, Jesus. Hallelujah, hallelujah. Hallelujah, Jesus. Hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah. Jesus, as we stand before you today, you have rightly said in the scriptures, all those who call out the name of God shall be saved. Lord, you cannot deny the cry of your beloved ones. However sinful he is or she is, however the person is away from you, you cannot deny the cry. And in the Bible, we see all those who have called out your name in their struggle and stress were delivered from their brokenness and their stress. And today, Lord, we ask you, give us the grace to call upon your name, not only during our time of danger and troubles, but every time, let the name of Jesus be on our tongues. Dear brothers and sisters, raise your hands up to heaven. Now, we call out the name of Jesus for some time. The name of Jesus is the powerful name God has given to us for deliverance and to get cured. Let us praise and call out the name of Jesus. Jesus. Jesus, 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 Jesus. In the name of Jesus, there is victory. In the name of Jesus, there is deliverance. Deliverance. In the name of Jesus, there is healing. Hallelujah, 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 hallelujah. Everybody, Jesus,
Hallelujah. Oh,